Good morning students, welcome to our maths class. We were in the chapter addition and subtraction in exercise 5.8. Let us see page number 76. These are writing sums or verbal sums we will discuss. See here, first question, page number 76, exercise 5.8. All of you open. First question, there is a village or a city given for us in the question. Men are there, men, father, grandfather, all those are called men. Again, women are there in the village, women, your mother and your grandparents, aunt, all those are called women. Women are there in the village. Remaining are children also there in the village. You are a child only, you know, for your family. Such children are there in different families. In the village or in the city, men are there, women are there, children also there. Three types of people. Okay, no? Then, there is a information for every type. Number of men in a village. Number of men in a village. How many men are there, it seems? 4,430 men are there in the village given. Number of women in a village. Number of women in a village. That is in a, we will write that. Number of women in a village. Is it clear for you? Number of women in a village is equal to 2,100. 4,430 are men. 2,100 are women. Then total of men and women we want. Total of men and women we want. Why? Because to find the number of children in the village or that city. Okay? Then total means addition only, you know. So we should add them. 0 and 0 addition 0. 3 and 0 is 3. 4 and 1 addition is 5. Okay, no? 4 and 2 addition is 6. Total of men and women in that village 6,530. Then the population of a village, that means a total population, all the people of the village, in that people, men, women, children, all the types will be there. Total population of the village, how much given? 8,000 given. In the 8,000 of total population, this many are men and women together. Okay, no? So, total population of a village is 8,000. Total of men and women in the village is given, what we got is addition 6,530. We need this number here so that we have added both in the top part of this answer. Am I correct? We need this addition part here. So, that's why we have added that part. So, 6,530 people are total of men and women. If at all, this number is subtracted from the total population of the village, surely we will get some answer. That answer is nothing but number of children belongs to that village. Am I correct? So, that is only last step, number of children in the village. That too, we will get with the subtraction. Suppose, in our family, total 6 people are there in our family. In that 2 are men and 3 are women. 2 are men and 3 are women. Then total of men and women how much? 2 men, 3 women. 2 men and 3 women. Total how much? 5. 5 are together of men and women. Actually 6 people are there in our family, I said. 6 people are there, but 2 are men, 3 are women, I said, no? 2 and 3 if we add, we will get 5. Total 6, from the 6 if I subtract this 5, we will get answer as 1. 6 minus 5 answer is 1, no? That 1 is, who is that 1? Men are, women are, children. Yes, children. One child is there in the family. Total 6 members in there in the family, I said. 2 are men are there, 3 are women are there, then 2 plus 3 gives you 5. If this 5 is subtracted from the total 6, 1 will be the answer. That 1 is nothing but the number of children of the family. One child only belongs to that family. Correct only, no? That only we are doing here subtraction to find the number of children of that village. Yes? That example was shown for a family. But here, total village we are seeing. Then subtraction. Here 0 minus 0 is 0 only. Here from 0 we cannot subtract 3. So we can take borrow. That method is known to us. 10 minus 3, 7. Here will be 9 only because borrow is given. 9 minus 5, 4. Then here from 8 we have given borrow. So 8 changed as 7. 7 minus 6 answer 1. Finally, how many children are there in the village? 1470 children are there in that village. Is it clear, students? Final answer is number of children in the village is this many. I hope it is very easy for you. We'll go for the question number 2. In the same page, page number 76, question number 2 we will check that. Now here, there is a person in this question. That person is having some money in his hand. That person is having some money in his hand or in his pocket. And in that money, he want to give some money to his daughter. Daughter is the girl child. Okay, no? Daughter is a girl child of the family. Son is a boy. That is a male child of the family. Okay, no? Boy. So, some money he want to give to his daughter. And again, no? Some money again he want to give to his son, and remaining money he want to give to his wife as a share of his daughter, share of the son, share of the wife. Let us see, that is only how much money that wife is going to get when the conditions are given like this. That is only first I have written in this question, share of daughter. That means how much money he want to give to his daughter. That is called share of daughter. That is given in the question. 2528 rupees this man want to give his daughter. Next, what to share of son? Share of son. That means some money he want to give to his son. How much money he want to give to his son? 3275 rupees. If at all we want to find the total share of the both the people, we should add now. The word total is saying that we should add it. That only I have written this step. Total share of son and daughter. What is the need of finding this total? In the next step, we want this answer. That's why I have to find the total share of son and daughter. That is addition. So both I have to add. When we add this, we will get an answer. We will see that. 8 and 5 addition is 13. 1 is carried and 3 is written down for 13. Now 1 and 2, 3. 3 and 7 addition is 10. 1 is written here and 0 is written to form 10. Am I correct? The next part, that is 1 and 5 addition is 6. 6 and 2 addition gives you 8. Am I correct, students? Next part, 2 and 3. 2 and 3 addition gives you 2 and 3 addition gives you 5. That 5 only written. You know how to add the numbers given. Okay. That is total share of son and daughter we got as 5803 rupees. Then money with a man to distribute. Total how much money is having by the man? That man is having some money in his pocket, I said in the beginning of this question. That only money with a man to distribute to the people who are around him, son, daughter and wife. That is 9000 rupees are there with him in his pocket. In that, how much money is given for daughter and son together? That is 5803 rupees already distributed. Still some more money is there in his hand or in his pocket. How much money is there in the pocket? That much money that fully given to his wife, it seems. That only given in the question. Then how much money was given to his wife? That is nothing but only subtraction. No? Suppose you are having 5 rupees in your hand. You have given 1 rupee to your small sister. 1 rupee gave to your sister. Again, 1 rupee given to the another sister. 1 rupee given to one sister. Another 1 rupee given to the another sister. Then total how much is given by you to both sisters? 1 rupee and 1 rupee addition is 2 rupees. Actually, 5 rupees with you. But 2 rupees given for both the sisters. Then how much money is with you? That is nothing but 3 rupees. How did you get that 3 rupees? Total 5 rupees minus the addition of both the sisters amount what is given, that is 2 rupees. 5 minus 2 gives you 3, that 3 rupees with you. But here, remaining money actually should be with a person. But that person want to give that money should to his wife. That's why we have written the step here. First, money with a man to distribute to the people who are around him in his family. That is 9000 rupees with him. In that 9000, total share shown in the above line. That means total money given for son and daughter is 5803. Then remaining money he want to give to his wife. Not only share of his wife. The money given to his wife by that person is nothing but with subtraction only, no? So we are subtracting that. Then borrowing needed here. 0 minus 3 not possible. So borrow, so we have taken 10 minus 3, 7. Yeah, actually 10 should be, but borrow given, no? That's why that is with 9 only. 9 minus 0 is 9. Here also actually 10 should be when we got borrow. Since that from 10 we have given borrow again, the 10 also changed to the 9. 9 minus 8 gives you 1. We know how to subtract it with borrowing. This 9 only gave borrow to others. So it becomes 8. 8 minus 5 gives you 3. Finally, money given to the wife is equal to 3197 rupees. 3197 rupees is the share of his wife. Then no money with him. Some money gave to daughter. Another part of money given to son, remaining money given to the wife. He is not having any money with him. His pocket is empty at that moment. Am I correct? Such a way the question is framed and given. We have identified the money which is allotted or given to his wife. Okay, no? That is the final answer for us. I hope the things are very clear for you. These are purely based on with steps and understanding. Ways are also taught to you, just go through the things given, also write in your classwork with the help of the photo. Thank you, children. With other part of teaching, we will go for the next class.